more ground forces and putting down a cannon inside of his Nacho, because he knows that Mutalisks are always a danger against Luxury, and he just better idea to be careful. A lot of Zerglings all over the place, meanwhile, for Luxury. I think, I'm not quite sure, but I think he has Zergling speed at this point. Trying to follow Probe Gear, I'm actually not quite sure. Also, Hydro's Den, as well as Aspire, now coming up, so we're going to see what he does. It's rather early. Hydra's Den has Zerglings on both sides of the natural Jungle Beast, so he might just be waiting for an opportunity to barrel down. Has a few Zerglings there at the top, but they're going to be ranged by that cannon. The cannon can be completely defended by probes. So in that regard, Luxury is not going to be able to barrel down and take out the natural anytime. Well, not right away, because he's going to need speed and he's going to need something else. Also, a hatchery being put down the natural. First Corsair now out, meanwhile, and that's going to start harassing that overlord, and there are no forces. I don't see anything to take care of that. Meanwhile, now speed up for the Zerglings. A lot of Zerglings being put down. So Luxury grouping up, massing up Zerglings from two directions. They're nothing but four Zealots and a Dragoon, as well as cannons to defend. So Luxury is actually going to go for this. He's going to attack from both directions. Not going to attack everything. Going to go with Zerglings from both sides. There's going to be attacked. The ones on the west are going to be attacked fairly well, but the Zerglings from the north are barreling down, killing a lot of probes. They're trying to block the cannon. Is actually going to manage to take the cannon down. A bunch of Zerglings from both sides, still reinforcing, doing a massive amount of damage here. Some Zerglings and attacking a lot. Zealots trying to defend as well as he can. Forge goes down. Dragoon's still alive. Some Zealots still alive. And most of the Zerglings have died at this point, but they've taken down a lot of the probes. Taken on one Forge. And, ooh, Jangbi holds. So many Zerglings barreling down, trying to get through. But overall, he holds. He's still pushing out with even more Zerglings, adding another hatchery. So we're going to see whether he pushes for a Hydra build. More cannons being put down. By Jangbi is also adding another forge inside of his main. Probably gonna go for upgrades. He lost the forge in natural. No, he's just rebuilding the forge in his main because it's so much danger there at natural. Meanwhile, Sunken's being put there at the 10 o'clock base by Luxury, also getting some Scourge out to take out those scouting Corsairs so he won't lose any more overlords. I still don't know whether he has the Spire, so I'm not quite sure whether he has Mutas yet or not. So that was quite a few Zergans now getting his second extractor as well, so he's going to be able to get for high tech, getting creep colonies inside of his natural as well as the 10 o'clock base. I'm going to see whether Jangbi is now pushing out with quite a large mass of force. He has, I think, 6, 7, maybe even 8 Zealots, as well as the Dragoon. We're going to see whether he actually pushes. No, he's actually going to push back. He's going to has speed, meanwhile, for the Zealots, so that's going to be a huge help. Temple Archive is always up, so Dark Temple. I'm going to see whether he goes for Dark Temple or just sticks to his forte of high temple. A lot of Corsairs, meanwhile, now in his main. Going to be some Scourge going to fly and going to try to pick one of those off. But there's going to be enough forces to take care of that. High Temple is going to be in my spot, the Temple Archive, so he knows he's going to have to be careful. I don't think Jangbi, he does have a decent amount of Corsairs, but I don't think he's going to have enough to really go down and kill enough overlords of Luxuries to go barrel in with Dark Templar. Meanwhile, now, good thing by Luxury overall, he's taken down forges twice, which means that he's definitely forced Jangbi to cancel his upgrades. No weapons won, which would have been almost ready at this point for him. Up yet, and he's actually gonna move into this natural. There's only one Sunken there, I think a few Hydras as well as Zealots. I think he's gonna need more than one Sunken there, though. The Zealots are not gonna be barreling down. There is a Hydras, there's a Lurker morphing in, and the Zealots are not actually gonna move. There is like a Sunken attack. Meanwhile, no, Luxury is gonna hold. He's gonna go for the pincer just now with the Zerglings. There's some Scourge there also, which are a little bit useful. Not gonna do it. Just one Sunken, trying to block off the Sunken as much as he can, but the Sunken is actually gonna go down. Some more Hydras now morphing in. Most of the Zerglings still alive, but now all gonna get taken down. There are still five Zealots as well. Dragoon now inside of the natural. Luxury now is gonna be in trouble. The Lurkers morph now. Just in time, and Jangbi running out. Did manage to take out some ground forces, losing a few of his own, but did manage to take out that Sunken, but no economic damage critically. Lurkers came in town. Now, High Templar on the other side, up for Jangbi, also reinforcing, putting down more cannons, but with those High Templar and those cannons, he's definitely going to be able to hold. Three Sunkens at the 10 o'clock base. I think Luxury might also be thinking of taking the main there. Managed to take down one Corsair as well, sacrificing a couple of Scourge from that. Robotics facility also now coming up for Jangbi. Meanwhile, Luxury running in with a Lurker. Has to be careful to barrel that at the correct location. He's just running around, trying to get inside, trying to position himself properly. Archon also now out, actually, for Jangbi. That's interesting. He didn't actually wait for Storms for those High Templar of his. Luxury on the other side, putting down another base at the 11 o'clock. So he's taking the main at the 11 o'clock alongside those natural Corsairs now moving in. So he is going to go for Overlord's kills. I don't see any anti-air for him. Meanwhile, no Hydralisks, nothing. And these Overlords are going to be turned into mincemeat here. Second Overlord going to go down. Third Overlord and three Overlords killed. And now just the Scourge moving. So that's awesome there for Jangbi. He didn't manage to do too much early on, but now he's killed a lot of Overlords. So that's going to really delay. And we're going to see whether Jangbi is actually going to try to go for the 10 o'clock. There are a lot of Sunken defending there, but Luxury has upgraded to Nidus Canal tech at this point, and we know he is going to prevent some expansions from Jambi. Jambi's actually moving on into a heavy Archon build, not actually using his High Templar for Storms, also getting upgrades for his Ground Force, not producing any more Corsairs, so I think he has enough at this point. Doesn't have weapons one yet. A lot of Scourges flying, around, trying to pick off all those Corsairs that are running around and massacring his Overlords. Decent force there. Some Corsairs not gonna... Ooh, take three Corsairs taken out by the Scourge, and only three or four left, so that's a pretty decent job there. Keeping luxury Jambi's Corsair number from rising too high. He's not producing anymore. Now he's going to focus on Ground Force. He has like 8 or 10 Zealots alongside a couple of Archons. Some Dragoons also now has weapons once. So we're going to see what he actually tries to push soon. Forced Luxury to build a Spore Colony inside of the Natural. And came far too late though. And Zealots are meanwhile going to penetrate the Natural at this 11 o'clock. 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock base. And going to spot that hatchery coming up. They're going to start attacking it, but there's going to be a lurker there in time to reinforce, so that's not going to happen. That hatchery will stay up, and Luxury will actually be able to get up another base. Meanwhile, Jambi's still only at two bases, so if Luxury gets this another base, he's also going for high tech. Meanwhile, if he actually manages to take to hold these bases, not prevent Jambi from taking on a third base, he will take a significant economic advantage. But no, Jambi is actually going to move towards the 3 o'clock and put down another base. Luxury now finally getting his fourth, finally getting mining there. Also, Jambi Mo also putting down cannons to defend the 3 o'clock. No other attack from Jambi, but I actually be thinking of moving out, taking down a random Scourge there, has some Corsairs alongside his ground army. Some Zergans, meanwhile, moving out at the north from Luxury. We're going to see where he actually tries to put on some pressure. Jambi now, decent size force of both air and ground units. Scourge going to push those Corsairs back for a small amount of time, but some of them going to get taken down. Luxury has to be very careful to defend his Overlords. Oh, losing even more Scourge. Oh, but managed to take down one or two more Corsairs. Oh, no, two of them. Only two more Corsairs there in the air. Luxury now defending his Natural with two Sunkens that he's putting up and a bunch of Lurkers everywhere. And Jambi is going to barrel down. And the Sunkens aren't already too, so all those Lurkers are going to take in a lot. Now he finally has those Zerglings out. Should be able to take out all of these forces of Jambi. Jambi has managed to do any sort of damage. Loses a lot of forces. There's also that Spore Colony. It takes out a Corsair. So Jambi, with a worthless attack, didn't have any observers. I don't think at least he had observers. Did not spot any forces there. Now going to move out with some Dark Templar. But I think that... I believe that Luxury has either Spore Colonies or... Overlords at most locations, so Jambi has to be very careful how he uses that. There's an advertisement there at the north, at the screen, at the top of the screen, which won't go away because it's bothering me, go away. Lots of Archons, and finally, I believe Jambi's now finally getting some High Templar, yeah, alongside his forces. Gonna need those storms, especially for those Lurkers. Now, more Creep Colonies being put down at the Natural, so he's. And a Defiler Man as well. We're going to see whether he uses those Creep Colonies for Sunkens or actually for Spores. Now, oh, the last of the Corsairs of Jambi's now finally get taken down. So Luxury actually might be getting himself back into this game. But Jambi now has a Shuttle out. I'm going to see whether he's going to storm the northern bases of Luxury's. If he's successful with that, he's going to be able to accomplish so much. Because at this point, it's 4 base versus 3 base. And that's a fairly decent position for Zerg. He's now putting Luxury now putting Nidus Canals down in all of his bases, trying to make sure he can reinforce. And now the shuttle is going to move in. I'm not quite sure what he has there. He actually